I don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
Me oh, we're either. Live. Are we live?
Yeah, we are. We're live. Oh,
okay. All right, still talking about our hair.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good morning. Today.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. I missed you last week.
I know. I forget what happened.
You were camping.
Oh.
You were coming back from camping.
I was in D.C. seeing the cherry blossoms. You're right.
Yeah.
That was nice. Yeah.
Good. Good. How was your weekend this weekend?
Good. Crazy. Which we were going to touch on a little bit, the market and the fact that the chaos is back.
It really is.
Yeah. I had a property in Allentown and it went with 23 offers on it, I guess.
Wow. So, congratulations.
Thank you. And it's good. I mean, it's good. I'm so happy for the sellers, but it's rough to have to make those sorry you didn't get it calls.
Well, and, you know, it's interesting because I have a client that had to work over the weekend and was excited that there was going to be a Tuesday evening open house. And so I contacted the agent and said, you know, I know you had an open house today. And, you know, what is your deadline? It's going to be Wednesday. She's like, I'm shutting down. She said, no need to even have a Tuesday. So my client didn't even get the opportunity to go into the property. She had that many just from over the weekend.
Yeah. So we're just back to it. And I think it's easy to like kind of blame your agent when you're not getting the properties and that, but it's just because we were talking to Orlando about that and you have to realize that it's the market and we're doing our best. And there's only so much when they call for highest and best, they're not coming back and negotiating. So you're putting in the highest offer that you have, the best offer that you have, and that's it.
I have a coming soon that's going active next week. And I actually had two agents ask if they could submit offers sight unseen.
Yeah.
And I'm like, nope, we're not even playing that game. I think I've got 17 showings the first day it goes active. It's just back to back to back.
I was shown another one over the weekend and the agent called and he's like, we have over 100 showings in a two day window. 100 showings.
It is a spring market.
It is.
But why don't we go through some numbers? We'll kind of see what happened from 2 weeks ago. We'll start with the new active. This is encouraging.
Mm-hmm. I thought you were taking it. Go ahead.
No, I was going to say, so more in the last 2 weeks that have come through. And we were talking about how last week they say was the biggest week in real estate for properties to go on the market. Yeah. So that whole spring market, we're here.
We're here.
334 versus 237 2 weeks ago.
And then coming soon, this is a little discouraging. 64 this week versus 110 last week. So we did see less coming soon, but more new active. So that's good.
And then under contracts, very consistent, 457 this past week versus 448 2 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm. Back on the market, holding it together still, 35 this week versus 32 last week.
Price reductions, 106 versus 93 2 weeks ago.
That kind of surprises me.
Why?
I don't know, because of how quick everything's flying. I'm surprised that we are still having that many price reductions.
Yeah. Well, unfortunately, people are thinking that because of the lack of inventory, they're thinking that, you know, they can get more than what warrants in the market.
Yep.
And then available listings, very consistent again.
Yep. So 1520 versus 1536. So yeah, very consistent.
So that is it. Short and sweet. Again, guys, if you have any questions about anything that's happening in the market, you are more than welcome to go ahead and just drop us a comment and let us know what you'd like us to address. And we'll go from there.
All right. Sounds good.
All right. Have a great week, everybody.
Bye.